I love you, Allah.
Allah talks about people, when their death comes, they say the following words. قَالَ رَبِّ ارْجِعُونَ. He, the criminal, the person who has neglected their life, when the time of death comes, they actually know that they're dying. And when the soul is coming out and reaches the gargling point, I'll tell you about the thought process. You know what they're thinking? They're saying, oh, our Lord, please return me. لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِيمَا تَرَكْتُ. Maybe I will compensate, do some good work instead of what I have left behind. But Allah replies by saying, وَلَنْ يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا. But Allah will not postpone the time of a person when their death comes. In another ayah he says, it will not be postponed, nor brought forward a single moment. My brothers and sisters in Islam, live the life with the advice of the Prophet ﷺ, which he said to Mu'adh radiallahu anhu, or was it Abu Dharr, or was it the man who came to him and said, Ya Rasulullah, when will the world end? You know, you expected today a talk about the signs of the last hour, and when the Dajjal will come out, and when the world will end. This is what the Sahabi said, Ya Rasulullah, mata sa'a, when will the world end? Tell me, entertain me, like a movie. For Rasul ﷺ knew that this person was asking the wrong question, he was after the wrong purpose. So he responded with a question, ماذا أعددت لها? What have you prepared for it? He's saying, what have you prepared for your sa'ah, for your time, when your world will end? My brothers and sisters in Islam, prepare for your time, and prepare from now. And do not look at the insignificant issues in life. There's something out there that says, life is like, or iman is like going into an aeroplane. I think that's what it says up there. I like that metaphor. The higher the aeroplane goes, the smaller the world looks. And iman is like that. The higher your iman rises, the smaller this worldly stuff, you know, these things you get upset about, these things you get annoyed about, the smaller they look. A brother said to me the other day, he says, I went and did this and did that for this sick person. Wallahi, never again will I do. I said, why are you saying that? He says, it took out a lot from me. Never again. I said, don't say never again, ya akhi. Think about the rewards that you worked for and don't lose your rewards, as Allah says. And do not lose your sadaqat, your acts of charity, bilmanni wal adha, by saying words of man, meaning, look what I did, I need praise, I need comfort. Wal adha, and then saying words that hurt other people. I did this for you and I did that for you, expecting praise from others. Don't do that. Work and anticipate only the ajr from who? Who's the ajr from? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not from people, my brothers and sisters. Not from people. I thank you for listening, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to relieve all the destitute among us, and those who are here and those who are around the world, from their misery and from their hardships. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our shortcomings, and to make this gathering of ours one that unites our hearts with theirs. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to relieve those who are in oppression from their oppression. O Allah, accept our dua. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our gathering in goodness. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ.